Friends, I welcome you in the third lecture on functional analysis. In second lecture, we studied some standard examples of Banach spaces. In today's lecture, we will study some more examples of Banach spaces. Last time, we had seen four standard examples of Banach spaces. Now, we will see some more examples of Banach spaces. Fifth example, in continuation to last lecture, is LPN. LPN consists of all n tuples of scalars x1, x2, xn, where these x1, x2, xn are scalars. Scalars means real or complex numbers. Throughout this course, remember that scalars means real or complex numbers. From context, it will be clear whether we are considering real or complex numbers. Further, vectors mean elements of vector spaces. Elements of vector spaces. Vector space elements will be called vectors. I repeat, vectors are elements of vector space and scalars are real or complex numbers. So LPN consists of all n tuples of scalars. The norm on LPN is defined as norm of x is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n mod xi raised to p and whole bracket raised to 1 by p. Equipped with this norm, you may call it as xp, where the writing subscript is optional. X denotes the vector x1, x2, xn. So equipped with this norm, LPN is Banach space. In order to prove that LPN is Banach space, you need to prove properties of norm. Further, you need to prove that it is complete metric space. In last two lectures, I had explained you how to prove that any set is Banach space. So by using your earlier knowledge of analysis, you can prove that LPN is Banach space. For detailed proof of the fact that LPN is Banach space, you please refer to the notes which I am providing to you. So LPN is Banach space. Next example is LP. LP is set of all sequences of scalars, all infinite sequences. If you want, I may write n is equal to 1 to infinity. Generally, we will be denoting sequences by xn. There are different notations for sequences. You may write sequence in this fashion also, xn, n takes value from 1 to infinity. And there are few other ways, but we'll stick to this. So xn, it's same as xn n is equal to 1 to infinity. It is set of all infinite sequences such that summation I is equal to 1 to infinity mod xi raised to p is convergent. Recall from the real analysis that if we have a sequence an of नॉन निगेटिव रियल नंबर्स, देन दिस नोटेशन डिनोट्स द फैक्ट दैट सीरीज इज कॉन्वर्जेंट. सो व्हाट डज दिस नोटेशन मीन? इट मीन्स दैट द सीरीज सिग्मा एन इज इक्वल टू 1 टू इन्फिनिटी मॉड ए एन इज कॉन्वर्जेंट. इन केस ए एन इज सिक्वेंस ऑफ नॉन नेगेटिव रियल नंबर्स, आई मे रिप्लेस ए एन बाय मॉड ए एन. सो दिस नोटेशन इज यूज्ड ओनली फॉर सीरीज ऑफ नॉन नेगेटिव रियल नंबर्स. सो एल पी इज सिक्वेंस ऑफ एल पी इज सेट ऑफ ऑल इनफाइनाइट सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ रियल नंबर्स सच दैट दिस सीरीज इज कॉन्वर्जेंट. द नॉर्म ऑन एल पी इज डिफाइंड एज नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू समेशन आई इज इक्वल टू 1 टू इन्फिनिटी मॉड एक्स आई रेस टू पी रेस टू 1 बाय पी. द होल एक्सप्रेशन रेस टू 1 बाय पी. अगेन एल पी इज बनाक स्पेस विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस नॉर्म. यू कैन प्रूव इट बाय वेरीफाइंग ऑल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉर्म एंड बाय वेरीफाइंग द फैक्ट दैट एल पी इज कंप्लीट नॉर्म लिनियर स्पेस, दैट इज कंप्लीट मेट्रिक स्पेस. नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज एल इन्फिनिटी रेस टू एन. सो एल इन्फिनिटी रेस टू एन कंसिस्ट ऑफ ऑल एन टपल्स विच वी मे कॉल इट एज सेट ऑफ ऑल फाइनाइट सिक्वेंसेस. फाइनाइट मीन्स एन टपल्स, देर आर ओनली एन कोऑर्डिनेट्स वेयर एक्स वन एक्स टू एक्स एन आर स्केलर. दीज आर स्केलर्स आर स्केलर्स. एल इन्फिनिटी एन इट्स सेट ऑफ ऑल एन टपल्स. द नॉर्म ऑन एल इन्फिनिटी एन इज डिफाइंड एज नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू सुप्रीमम एज सेट ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट्स इज फाइनाइट. यू मे से इट इज मैक्सिमम एज वेल इन दिस केस. सो सुप्रीमम ऑफ मॉड एक्स वन मॉड एक्स टू मॉड एक्स एन. फॉर अ ब्रेविटी और सिंप्लिसिटी यू कैन राइट इट इन दिस फैशन शॉर्टर नोटेशन. सुप्रीमम ऑफ मॉड एक्स आय वेयर आय टेक्स वैल्यूज फ्रॉम 1 टू एन. यू मे यूज द सबस्क्रिप्ट इन्फिनिटी एज वेल टू डिनोट दैट इट इज इनफाइनाइट नॉर्म. हियर ऑल्सो यू मे यूज द सबस्क्रिप्ट. इट इज ऑप्शनल टू राइट दिस बिकॉज फ्रॉम कंटेक्स्ट इट बिकम्स क्लियर विच नॉर्म वी आर कंसिडरिंग ऑन एल इन्फिनिटी एन. सो इक्विप्ड विथ दिस नॉर्म एल इन्फिनिटी एन इज बनाक स्पेस. इट इज सी एन एल एस कंप्लीट नॉर्म लिनियर स्पेस, दैट इज बनाक स्पेस. For detailed proof of all these examples, you please refer to the notes which I am providing to you. The next example of Banach space which we will study is L infinity. L infinity. L infinity consists of all bounded sequences of scalars. Remember that this notation whether I write xn or xn n is equal to 1 to infinity, it denotes same thing. These are equivalent. Most of the time I'll stick to this notation. Okay, so this is denotes the infinite sequence where xn is scalar and it satisfies the property that every sequence is bounded sequence. So xn is bounded sequence. What is bounded sequence? Sequence xn is bounded if there is constant m, positive constant, such that mod xn is less than or equal to m for all n. This is definition of bounded sequence. What is L infinity? It is set of all bounded sequences of scalars. Xn is bounded sequence and xn is scalar. Okay. On L infinity, we define the norm of vector as norm of x is equal to, before I proceed, let me point out here that x is a vector or n tuple x1, x2, xn. Okay. Just like it was in LPN. So norm of x is equal to supremum of mod xi, where I takes values from 1 to infinity. It takes all possible values. For clarity, let me make it strictly less than, that is better, or it is precise to say that I is less than infinity means it takes all possible values. It is supremum of all absolute values or modulus of its terms. Norm of x, you may write here norm x infinity. In order to distinguish between these two norms, you may put here n, and similarly n here if you want. As I mentioned, it is optional to write this. You may simply say norm x, and in case you want to distinguish, you may put subscripts or superscripts whenever required in order to avoid confusion. So norm of x infinity is supremum of mod xi, where I runs from 1 to infinity. It is set of all bounded sequence. Again, L infinity is Banach space. Let X be a topological space. X be a topological space. Or let us say it is a metric space. Both are correct. X be a topological space, and Cx denotes set of all bounded and continuous functions. Let me be precise. It denotes set of, in case it is compact, we may remove the condition bounded. Set of all continuous and bounded functions and bounded स्केलर वैल्यूड, बाउंडेड स्केलर वैल्यूड मीन्स रियल और कॉम्प्लेक्स वैल्यूड, स्केलर वैल्यूड इन ब्रैकेट आई विल पुट रियल और कॉम्प्लेक्स वैल्यूड फंक्शंस, रियल और कॉम्प्लेक्स वैल्यूड फंक्शंस ऑन एक्स. In set, in the set form, I could write cx as f from x to r, in bracket I will put c, r or c, set of all those functions which are bounded and continuous. So it simply consists of all those functions, real or complex valued, from on x which are bounded and continuous. The norm on cx is defined as norm of f is equal to supremum of mod fx where x belongs to x, where x belongs to x. Then cx is Banach space, it is complete norm linear space. It is one of the standard results that you may be familiar with this. So CX is Banach space. In particular, if we do know, we have closed and bounded interval AB, then CAB is also Banach space, where CAB denotes set of all continuous functions on closed interval AB. In this case, every continuous function on closed interval AB will be bounded because AB is compact space. So no need to put condition of boundedness here. It is Banach space. Let us recall all the examples which we have studied. From examination point of view, I request you to go through the detailed proofs of all these examples which we have studied. By using preliminary knowledge of your real analysis or topology course, you can easily prove that these are Banach spaces. Let us briefly revise the examples which we have studied. First example which we had studied is R, second C. All these are vector spaces, nonlinear spaces, metric spaces, and in fact complete metric spaces, that is Banach spaces. R, C, Rn, Cn, then in today's lecture we defined some more Banach spaces, Lpn, Lp, then L infinity raise n, L infinity, finally we studied Cx, and in particular Cab is also Banach space. So I request you to go through the detailed proofs of each of these examples. I have provided you step by step proofs for each of these examples. You need to prove four properties of norm, and you need to verify the fact that these are complete metric spaces. Thank you.